reverse.
Glass bottle with poison on it.
On your mark, get set, go!
One of you girls, we should come over here.
It's not back there. Won't be past the altar. I'll be back here. Oh, man, they're looking all around close. Who is the best detective? Will it be the boys or will it be the girls? Alright. It might be in the middle rows as well. Look behind the seats, in the songbook racks.
Look underneath of the seats. I wonder where it's
at. Give them a hot or a cold clue.
I have to walk and find out where it's hot or cold. I wonder where I am. Tonight called the barn door.
mother had chopped up a whole bunch of hot peppers while he was on the way out to feed the chickens. And an idea came up in his head. Mother was going to make chili, and she had hot pepper flakes that was in a shake container. And she had those diced hot peppers all ready to go in our chili. Jimmy thought that would be really funny if he got all those hot peppers and he put it into the chicken feed and fed it to the chickens. So Jimmy stuffed a whole bunch of it in his pocket, went outside and put it in the chicken feed, and then threw it out to the chickens. And when the chickens started eating that, they were getting those hot peppers, their beaks were turning bright red. Chickens were flying all over the yard, going crazy, eating those jalapeno peppers. Feathers were flying. Jimmy thought it was hilarious. He was laughing so hard until Dad came out.
"Now, Jimmy, you have to stop this getting in trouble and mischief all of the time. Why aren't you listening to Mother when she tells you to behave? Why are you always getting into trouble?"
Jimmy hung his head.
"I don't know, Dad. Sometimes the things just sound fun."
"Well, Jimmy, I'm going to teach you a lesson."
Jimmy thought, "Uh-oh, I'm in big trouble. I'm going to get grounded or get a spanking." But Dad handed him a big pail of nails. What was he going to do with nails? Jimmy said,
"I don't understand, Dad. What am I going to do with these nails?"
"Well, Jimmy, every time you get in trouble, I'm not going to discipline you. I want you to take the nail out to the barn door, take the hammer, and pound, 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 pound that nail into the barn door."
Wow, that seemed pretty cool to Jimmy. Instead of getting in trouble, all he had to do was take a nail and pound it in the barn door? That was really lots easier than getting grounded. So Jimmy nodded his head that he understood. The very next day, Jimmy again. He forgot and left the barn door open after the cow was milked, and the kitty cat got into the milk bucket again, drank up all of the milk before they got the bucket inside. Jimmy took the nail out of the bucket, took it out to the barn door, took his hammer, pound, 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 pound the nail into the barn door. That wasn't so bad. Made Jimmy feel kind of bad. The next day he got in trouble again. Out went a nail, into the barn door, pow, 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 pow. And day after day after day, Jimmy kept getting in trouble and having to pound those nails into the barn door until the barn door was so full of nails, you could hardly even see the barn door. Then one day came where Jimmy looked into the bucket and all of the nails gone. He had gotten in so much trouble, he'd used up all of the nails. Jimmy felt sad. So back into Daddy went. This time he had big tears coming down his eyes.
Dad, all my nails are gone out of the bucket. I don't know what to do. I didn't realize I was getting in that much trouble. Now what's going to happen?"
"Well, Jimmy, I'm glad that you have come to the point now where you have an empty bucket."
Jimmy looked at his dad with big eyes.
"But Dad, the empty bucket means all the nails are in the barn door. I got in so much trouble."
"Well, Jimmy, now you realize that this trouble you've been getting into, those have been sins. Not just mischief, not just fun.
in his hands and in his feet for you, Jimmy. For all the times that you've been getting in trouble, it's been like you've been pounding the nails into Jesus' hands and feet. Jimmy, your eyes, that was true. He had been hurting Jesus. Every time that he was sinning, Jesus had taken the punishment for his sins, and he was hurting Jesus. Not just his mom and dad, but Jesus. Jimmy dropped his head. I feel real bad, Dad. I want to ask Jesus to forgive me. Jimmy asked Jesus to please come into his heart, to wash his heart all clean, to take away all those sins, all that disobedience, all that mischief, and what he thought was fun trouble, to take it all away. But Jimmy, when he went back out to the barn door, he seen that barn door was still all full of nails. Yes, now he was happy. Now he had Jesus in his heart, and Jesus had cleansed his heart all clean. But the door was still full of nails. So Dad told Jimmy,
"Okay, son, now take the hammer, turn it around the other way, and pull all those nails out of the barn door."
Jimmy thought that was a great idea. If his heart was all clean, now that he asked Jesus to come into his heart, he wanted the barn door to be all good and clean too. So Jimmy worked all day long with the hammer, pulling the nails out of the barn door. And when he was finished, he looked at the barn door, and now the barn door had all these holes in it still. Horrible holes. Even though he pulled out all the nails, look at all the holes that's still in the barn. Jimmy looked, and it wasn't just shiny pretty red anymore. It was all scarred up. Jimmy's dad said,
"Now, Jimmy, you see, when we do things, that scars our hearts too. When we sin, it can't be all erased. Jesus makes our hearts all clean. But when you've done something bad, it doesn't just hurt you, it hurts others. And you know what? Girls, boys, mom and dad, when we sin, it's putting scars on our heart, scars on our life. Even after we come to the Lord and ask Him to forgive us and to wash us clean, there's still scars. And that's why when you're young, you need to ask Jesus to forgive you of your sins. Ask Jesus into your heart right now. So when you get older, you don't have all those scars that's in your heart. Jesus don't want you to be scarred up. Have you ever had a scar before on your arm? Yeah, they don't go away, do they? Oh, the pain might not be there anymore, but the scar is still there. That's why Jesus wants you to commit your life to Him right now, so that you don't have all of those scars on your life like that barn door was after Jimmy had to pull all those nails out. So today is the day of salvation. While you're young, the Bible says that you should give your heart, commit your life to the Lord, so you don't have scars on your heart and life.
And regrets of things you wish you had never done.
Because you can't go back and change things. If you bloody your sister's nose, she's got blood coming down her nose, you feel really bad, but you can't go back and take that fist away from her nose, can you? No, you already did it. And that's the way with sin. We've already committed sin, and our hearts are full of scars. We can't take it back.
Jesus but help us to say no to sin,
right.
No to temptation.
Right.
Let's stand. I want to know who's happy about being a Kiss Crusade tonight. All right, well, I want to see your smiley faces.
I'm Right here behind the knife. It's not.